This is Optimal Finance Daily, episode 420, Money Doesn't Matter Until It Does, by Mr. 1500 with budgetsaresexy.com. And hi, everybody. Welcome to the Friday edition of Optimal Finance Daily. I'm Dan, your host and narrator, and I am here bringing to you each weekday some of the best personal finance blogs on the planet in audio format. And don't forget, we do book giveaways to random people on our mailing list. So if you're not on that list yet, please do come by oldpodcast.com and enter your email address so you can be part of it. And I'll give you a reminder about that at the end. So for now, let's hear today's post as we optimize your life. Money Doesn't Matter Until It Does, by Mr. 1500 with budgetsaresexy.com. My cover as a blogger was blown last year when a story about us went viral. I knew something was wrong when the blog went down. When it finally came back up, I had over 30,000 page visits and it was still before noon. On that day, we weren't so anonymous anymore. We then started getting texts from friends and relatives. Hey, you're on Yahoo! You have $1 million? What? Huh? To my surprise, it turned out to be a more painless experience than I had assumed. No one asked us for money. No one treated us any differently. I was hoping that the article would trigger some interesting conversations about money, but that didn't happen either. Life moved on. Except for one person who did want to talk money. Aunt Kay loves her job. One family member was excited to learn about our secret lives. The first conversation took place last year when we had the big publicity. It went something like this. Aunt Kay: That's so awesome you're planning to retire. Congrats! Me: Thanks. How about you? At what age do you see yourself retiring? Not anytime soon. I absolutely love my job. I do it for free. I'd like to retire, but probably not until 65. That's wonderful. If you're doing what you love and you happen to get paid for it, that's hardly working. I know, it's amazing. Unfortunately, Aunt Kay's bliss was not to last. A couple months ago, we saw her again and she was singing a different tune. While Aunt Kay loves her core job, there are other problems. She works in a school district that has issues with administration. The state that she teaches in is also mismanaging the teacher's retirement fund, so she's worried that all the money she's saving may be blown by politicians. I feel bad for Aunt Kay. She loves teaching, but the circumstances around it have changed. Just last year, saving money wasn't a priority, and she dismissed the idea of financial independence. Now, she worries that she'll never be able to stop working when she's finally ready to. Excuses, excuses, excuses. I hear folks making excuses for not saving all the time. Here are some of my favorites. I love my job. Aunt Kay's excuse is the most common one that I hear. If you love your job, that's awesome. What an amazing gift in a world where many folks dread their 9-to-5. You've got something wonderful there. However, will your job always love you? Plenty of folks who worked at Enron love their jobs too. There are always other factors at play. Robots and artificial intelligence are going to start taking more and more jobs. This will be a major societal change that you don't want to be on the wrong side of. I'm going to die young. This is the favorite excuse of a good friend. He insists that he will die before he'd ever retire, so he doesn't save. I'm not sure why. Both of his parents are in their 90s and he has no serious health problems. And why would he want to bet on an early death anyway? What's the backup plan if you don't die? The money won't be there for me anyway, so why bother? Bad things happen to good folks. Maybe you know someone who retired in 2008 right before the Great Recession clobbered us all. Maybe a family member got taken by a Bernie Madoff character. This stuff happens, but not to most. Put your money away and stop worrying. I could never do that. A friend recently lamented her financial position. We have nothing saved. I replied with, get rid of the new SUV. And rent your mother-in-law's apartment on Airbnb. And take local vacations instead of exotic ones. Every single suggestion was met with the same response. I could never do that. Well, I hope you plan on working until a ripe old age because you know the whole retirement thing. You're never going to be able to do that. Money doesn't matter until it does. My mantra in life is this: hope for the best, but prepare for the worst. Optimism is the only way to go through life, and a little preparation can make you a better optimist. Because I've taken care of myself financially, I'm prepared to deflect the curveballs that life throws at me. Money doesn't matter most of the time, but when it does, and you don't have it, it's going to hurt. To the folks who make excuses for not saving money, I say this. Financial independence isn't about quitting your job. It's about options. If you love your job, stay there. It's much better to work because you want to than because you have to. And also, you get nowhere running on the hedonic treadmill. Stuff doesn't bring long-term happiness. Spending time with loved ones and meaningful activity does. A frugal, simple life is the most efficient and rewarding way to live. If there is anything true about life, it's that it's an ever-changing, unpredictable journey. If you would have told me 5 years ago that I'd no longer be programming computers or have a job, I would have thought you were crazy. But the serendipitous turns of life are what makes it fun and interesting. Just save some money so you can embrace the fun opportunities when they present themselves. Save enough so you never have to worry. Money doesn't matter until it does. You just listened to the post titled Money Doesn't Matter Until It Does by Mr. 1500 with budgetsaresexy.com. And Mr. 1500 is a guest author over at Budgets Are Sexy. He writes a Wednesday column and is the founder of his own financial blog, which is 1500days.com. And don't forget, as I mentioned at the top of the show, we give away books to random people on our mailing list, and we've given away a lot of them in the last month. But we also give away helpful spreadsheets to help optimize your finances. One of them even comes with a free video tutorial. It's all free to you and available just by being on our weekly newsletter mailing list. To get all of that, simply come by oldpodcast.com and enter your email address. And that is 420 episodes of Optimal Finance Daily now in the books. As always, thank you so much for your support and for listening in every day. I'll be back at you with more posts next week. So have a great weekend, and I will catch you on Monday, where your optimal life awaits.
Hello, Life Optimizer. This is Justin Mollick, creator and producer of this podcast, but also Optimal Living Daily, the show where I read to you from even more blogs covering finance, productivity, minimalism, personal development, and more from incredible bloggers like Derek Sivers, Zen Habits, Mark and Angel, The Minimalists, and all the ones you hear on this show too. So if you enjoyed today's episode and like taking amazing blogs on the go, come on over to Optimal Living Daily and subscribe to that one too. And together, we'll start optimizing your life.
You've been listening to Optimal Finance Daily. Be sure to hit the subscribe button to stay up to date on each new episode and head to oldpodcast.com. That's OLDpodcast.com for a free gift as well as more actionable tips and resources to help you maximize your potential. Thanks for joining us, and remember, your optimal life awaits.